Breaking news, as Jeff Hardy has been released by WWE. Rey Mysterio also said to be making a career-changing announcement today, and multiple NXT stars have undergone surgery. Stay tuned to find out more. This is a horrible, horrible video to be doing. A man who has been plagued by demons in the past, and reports circulated earlier this week that Jeff Hardy had been sent home from a live show,
yep.
Following reports that he was sluggish in the ring.
Yeah, so there was a six-man tag match. It was the Bloodline versus Jeff Hardy, King Xavier, and Drew McIntyre as well. And I think Hardy started out strong, and then throughout the match, you can see he's getting visibly more sluggish and everything. He hot tags into Drew McIntyre, and we see him just laying on the apron, and then all of a sudden, he just decides to kind of get up, walk through the crowd, and he just never came back.
Absolutely, and we've tried to be very, very optimistic about this in our output, because Jeff is certainly no stranger to various personal demons, but we tried to be optimistic about it because we weren't sure exactly what was going on, and we all hoped that it was just, you know, an off day or something was wrong. But
yeah.
A lot of people, of course, speculating that this could be linked to previous drug issues. But now Jeff Hardy has indeed been released by WWE. Sean Ross Sapp of Fightful breaking the news. Mere minutes ago, Fightful has learned WWE has released Jeff Hardy. He followed up saying, I've heard WWE offered Jeff Hardy help and rehab, and it was not accepted. Here's to hoping things get better for him. And that's the real heartbreaking bit, right?
Yeah.
Because if he's not accepting the help that they're offering, then that is a very, very concerning thing to hear. This is following, like, Jeff's career. The trajectory seemed to be going up after Survivor Series, where he was like man of the match.
Yeah,
in that.
Without a doubt.
And he was awesome. The crowd was so behind him. We were all behind him at home. And it looked like maybe, just maybe in the future, with the crowd support that was there, and a lot of people were asking for a Universal title match. They wanted to see Jeff in the main event picture once again, something that we've not seen for so, so very long in WWE. Obviously, that will no longer be the case. Matt Hardy mentioned earlier this week that Jeff was in a good
place. He didn't want to speak on Jeff's behalf or anything like that, but he was like, he's at home, he's okay. Like, he'll speak when he wants to speak, but he's all right. And then obviously, as you were saying, it is just heartbreaking because you watch Jeff's Broken Skull Sessions, which came out recently over Thanksgiving, I think, and he was so optimistic about the future. He was like, I'm in a very good place now compared to where I have been in the past and everything. And he was talking about pitching all these ideas and everything to Vince McMahon and wanting to do all this stuff, get another Universal title run, or be in the main picture at least as well. And as we were saying, it's just heartbreaking to see. I think I read something as well where someone asked him, you know, obviously about his struggles and everything, and they were like, how is it sort of staying away from all that? And he's like the substance stuff is okay, but the alcohol is around everywhere. And it's such a shame. Obviously, a lot of these wrestlers hurting from what they've been doing.
Jeff's been doing it for so long.
He has.
His body, the spots that he's done in the past, the style that he wrestles in is incredibly damaging.
Of course.
So it's unfortunately not a surprise that you know, wrestlers do have to rely on various substances. Mm-hmm. I guess in this case, WWE have essentially been left with no alternative. That's the way that I'm reading this. The fact that they've offered him help, they've offered him rehab, and he hasn't accepted it means that he can't go out there and be a performer because he can't be trusted to perform with the stuff that he's dealing with, clearly. So we'll finish this section of the video by just sending our best to Jeff Hardy. I speak on behalf of both of us when I say that this guy was a hero for us growing up, watching the Attitude Era. You especially, he's your guy.
Literally the first proper wrestling match I ever saw and got invested in was that Triangle Ladder match at WrestleMania 16, and seeing Jeff Hardy, I was like, I'm hooked. Wrestling's the best, and it is really heartbreaking. And we just wish nothing but the best for Jeff Hardy, and really hope he gets the helps that he needs.
Totally. We'll move on with a few more stories now. It's going to be a weird one to sort of transition to. Rey Mysterio making a career-changing announcement today. This is something that he's teased on social media. He tweeted, December 9th, 2021. Remember that date. That's today, by the way. I'll reveal some very exciting news that will change change the history of Rey Mysterio. More details coming soon. Rey Mysterio is, of course, the cover star of the new WWE 2K22 video game.
Got to be.
You reckon it's that? Career changing.
Career changing, that's the thing. So we've been, things have come up online, especially on Twitter, sort of the day prior to yesterday, which was the 7th for us, well, for everybody, literally for everybody.
That's how time works.
That is how time works. There was a steelbook or some artwork for a steelbook that has seemingly been leaked by a French website. Mm-hmm. And that could potentially be it. Rey Mysterio's face is very much prominent on the cover. It is literally just the cover, mm-hmm. is his face. So, I mean, perhaps that is it. Career changing. Is it, maybe?
It's probably going to be an NFT or something.
Can you imagine? Can you imagine?
Stay tuned. Obviously, that's going to be announced tonight at 8 p.m. Eastern. We'll keep you updated on that. So check out tomorrow's video if you don't catch it before. And we'll let you know what the deal is with Ray Ray. Next up, multiple NXT stars undergoing surgery. First of all, Flash Morgan Webster, who shared on Instagram. Shoulder surgery went well, and they gave me a cool sling and some sexy socks. I'm going to jump off socials for a bit and just focus on rehab. Very, very talented. Performer on the NXT UK brand. Mm-hmm. He's awesome, so we just send him our best as well.
Absolutely.
And hopefully he'll be back in the ring sooner rather than later. And also, another NXT UK name, Dani Luna.
Yeah, so she shared on Instagram as well, a month ago I tore my ACL, which means I can't wrestle for a long ass time. Today I got it fixed. I miss wrestling like mad and this obviously sucks a lot, but I'm feeling good and I'm so excited to start moving forward. So they're both obviously two-thirds of South Wales subculture on NXT UK. And yeah, they're some of the best parts about NXT UK as well. So just, again, wish nothing but the best for them and hopefully we'll see them back when they're ready to go.
Totally.
And it'll be a good time.
It's certainly going to be a while for Dani Luna, like a torn ACL is a lengthy recovery period. So, fingers crossed we see them back sooner rather than later, though. Moving over to the NIL initiative that WWE announced earlier this week, which is their newly formed sort of scheme that provides a pathway to becoming a fully fledged WWE superstar from being a collegiate athlete.
You'll get there. You're doing good.
Shaken up, to be honest. I'm gutted. I'm truly gutted. So this is the Name, Image and Likeness program. And 15 new signees have been announced here. We'll run through these as quick as possible. And fingers crossed I don't mess up the pronunciation on any of these. I will. Carlos Aviles, we've got Haley Kavinda, Hannah Kavinda, AJ Ferrari, Lexi Gordon, Aaliyah Hutchins, John Cran, Glenn Logan, Isaac Odubesson, Mason Paris, Masai Russell, John Seaton, Joe Spivak, Dalton Wagner, or Wagner, ooh, I'm not sure which. They've already got her.
They do. Yeah, could be his brother or something.
Don't need another one. Just nobody in wrestling is called Dalton. Just go with that.
Yeah, but it could just be like Kane and Undertaker thing. Again, do you reckon?
And Riley White, and these are from all over the state. You've got people there from Ohio State, you've got Fresno, Oklahoma, Portland, so all over the shop. And the idea is that WWE, of course, are no longer looking at independent wrestlers as their main sort of hiring aim. They're looking at building superstars from the ground up and having some sort of ownership over them and the creation of them.
Yeah.
So we send them all of our best. Finally, a huge WWE Hall of Famer making a GCW debut. He is literally huge. He's massive.
He is.
He's big.
He likes spaghetti.
He likes spaghetti. Ravioli.
Ravioli, sorry.
Thank you very much. You know what we're talking about. Kevin Nash. GCW announcing that he is coming home to Detroit and visiting GCW for the first time on Friday, January the 14th. Plus, also on the card, Rhino's back.
Whoa.
Alex Shelley, Jacobs, Sabu.
Big old card. It's going to be a big one.
Tickets are available now. I know everything that we did there in the second half of the video, with total respect, is inconsequential compared to the first half, the story that Jeff Hardy has been released by WWE. I cannot express the heartache that the office has just gone through reading that news.
Literally.
The collective sigh. We are truly gutted because he's awesome. He's awesome. And it's been a very... It's a personal story, isn't it? This isn't about him being a wrestler, really. This is about him being a human being. Mm-hmm. And we've all followed very closely because of the love and respect that we have for Jeff Hardy. We've all followed very, very closely. And things look to be going so well. So it's absolutely gutting to read that he has been released. And we just pray that he does get the help that he needs.
Yeah.
And a lot of people are obviously going to be looking out for him in the near future. And Jeff, you're the man. So I know you're not watching. But Jeff, like... Good. I hope you're all right.
Yeah,
don't know what without else to a say. Doubt.
Thank you for everything.
Yeah, thank you. Cheers. It's not over yet. Things are gonna be.
They will.
Things are on the up, right? Things will get better. So, Jeff, all the best. Thank you very much for watching this news video. Take care.